Measurement of angles, level 2. In this video, we will go over how to classify angles by sizes. In geometry, angles are classified into 6 categories according to their measures. An acute angle is an angle whose measure is greater than 0 degrees and less than 90 degrees. The angle shown can be classified as an acute angle. Acute angles are the smallest, being between but not including 0 and 90 degrees. A way to remember what acute angle look like is by remembering that small things tend to be cute. The word acute comes from the Latin word acutus, which means sharp or pointed. Let's take a look at the next angle. A right angle is an angle whose measure is 90 degrees. The angle shown can be classified as a right angle. Notice that a right angle is indicated by the square corner placed in the angle. This symbol will be used throughout this course to label right angles. So never assume that an angle looks right, unless stated otherwise. Right angles are one of the most common angles in geometry. This is why it has its own symbol. Notice that if an angle is labeled with this symbol, the angle measure in degrees is usually omitted. This symbol is also used to describe a special type of intersection between two lines. When two lines form a right angle, they are said to be perpendicular. We will go over perpendicular lines in greater detail in a much later video. For now, it is sufficient to understand that perpendicular lines form right angles. So the rays or line segments that form a right angle are also said to be perpendicular. Sometimes the word orthogonal and normal are also used to describe lines that form right angles. In this course, we will use perpendicular. Let's take a look at the third type of angle. An obtuse angle is an angle whose measure is greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. The angle shown can be classified as an obtuse angle. The word obtuse comes from the Latin word obtusus, which means blunt. You can think of an obtuse angle as an angle that is greater than a quarter revolution around a circle and less than half a revolution around a circle. Let's take a look at the next angle. A straight angle is an angle whose measure is 180 degrees. Notice that a straight angle forms a straight line. The angle shown can be classified as a straight angle. Either side of a straight angle could be considered to be the interior or exterior of the angle. This angle is also referred to as a flat angle, since the sides of the angle are pointing in opposite directions. The two sides form a single straight line through the vertex of the angle. The last two angles are rarely used in geometry, but we will go over them so that you can be acquainted with them. A reflex angle is an angle whose measure is greater than 180 degrees. This angle is denoted by a curved arrow that starts on one side and rotates on the other side of the angle. In this course, unless a curved arrow is included, as shown, we will assume that the angle is not a reflex angle. As mentioned in the previous video, we will mainly be dealing with angles that measure between 0 degrees, exclusive, and 180 degrees, inclusive. This means that when we refer to an angle without qualifying it, we will assume that we are referring to the smallest angle, unless we specify that it is a reflex angle. The final angle is called a full angle. A full angle is an angle that measures exactly 360 degrees. This angle is not widely used. If you continue to increase a ray or line segment of an angle counterclockwise, one complete revolution, until it coincides with the other ray or line segment, then we say that the measure of the angle is 360 degrees. One can also argue that this is the same as an angle that measures 0 degrees. The first four types of angles are most commonly used in a first course in geometry, and this will be the case for this course. In general, you should become familiar and have a sense of how the various angle measures look like when measured in degrees. you should be able to recognize the following common angles on sight and be able to sketch them yourself. These angles include 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 135 degrees, 180 degrees, 225 degrees, 270 degrees, and 315 degrees. These angles will be extremely important to know later on in this course and in future math courses. Alright, in our next video, we will go over the parts of a degree and congruent angles.